It's really a great day for all of us here at Chichetekero Hospice. As Dr. Irene King, I can call her our mother, the founder of this place. And everybody is happy. I also thank God for keeping her to reach that age.
Dr. King, I'm imagining I'm sitting close to you. May you enjoy this day. It's a special day for you. It comes once in a year, and I wish we are nearby. I could have hugged you. Happy birthday, Dr. King. We still love you. We miss you. All the patients, from deep down my heart, I say a happy, happy, happy birthday. May you enjoy this day. I wish you all the best. She has this heart for these people, for the patients, for people that are dying. She gave me, you know, she's actually my model. Even if I never told her, she's my model. And from that, I had that interest in taking care of the people that are chronically ill. But when I met her, looking at the way she was carrying out her duties, actually I was encouraged. She gave me that impetus to go, to continue.
Hello, Eileen. Just to wish you a very happy birthday. I'm delighted to be here to say happy birthday on your 80th birthday. It's a great achievement. Just like to say thank you to you for your support for all the SMAs when you were here, all those difficult guys who we've had to tell them about their health and look after themselves, and you did a lot of that for us. And also the time Fergus died, I really appreciate your help that time. You were very good to us and very strong and very supportive and appreciated very much, and all down through the years. So you've been a great friend of SMA here in Zambia, so well done to you, and thank you very, very sincerely. And I wish you God's blessing now for your future, and that you'll enjoy the rest of your retirement. Well done.
Yeah.
The very fact, of course, that she saw the need to set up Chicheta Kello, it tells you what kind of person Dr. Keane is. And she was a doctor in the hospital, and she saw the patients, how they were suffering, and lying on the floor, and not very difficult in circumstances.
Happy birthday. It's really nice if we can say hello even though we can't be with you. And hello to everybody else there with you all too. It would be lovely to share the day.
And have a wonderful day.
Evening, I think it is, isn't it? Our team have done a huge amount of work so that they can send you all their love, and I know you really will enjoy it. I also have another email that I'd like to read for you. This one says, Dear Dr. Keane, my name is John Mpundu. I was at Chicheta Kello Hospice from 2005 to 2006 time frame. I was the young Zambian who had tumours removed from my lower lumbar region. Because of your help and of the hospice, I am doing fine, working on therapy to help gain feeling in my legs. I'm always hopeful that I will walk again. With God, anything is possible. Just look at yourself in the mirror. It is a work of perfection. I keep you constantly in my prayers. I hope that God may guide you through good times and through bad times. May he perfect your hands to healing perfection. Thank you for taking care of me and everything you have done. May you not only be blessed on your birthday, may you be surprised by the blessings through the year. We hope that your birthday was wonderful, and we hope this year is filled with fun and adventure. Happy birthday, Dr. Keane. Love from John Mpundu. He now lives in Seattle.
Many, many more wonderful years ahead of you. We are delighted to get the opportunity to wish you a happy birthday, and myself in particular now, because I have great memories of you, and I don't want to embarrass you, but I would like to say this much. You helped me so much when I was sick after Fergus died, and you came every day, and I'll never forget that, Eileen. It was a real sign of comradeship and love. Another little incident that happened, which is a big incident in somebody else's life, was today, as it works out, the gospel was, it was about Lazarus, who was at the rich man's gate and was full of sores, as we know the story. And he died and went up to heaven. And then the rich man went down below. That gospel had been read on a Sunday, and here was I going around Chipulukusu, and I come across this old lady living alone in a house, all alone in a little hut, not a house, really a hut, and full of sores. And I said to myself, God, if there's not a message there for me now, what can I do for this woman? And of course, I must have mentioned it to somebody at home when I got home, and they all, I might have been Liz herself, who said, go to Chicheta Kello. So I did. And to make a long story short, we brought the poor woman. I think my brother was visiting at the time. You remember the Unbelievables had come to town. You said that. Well, we brought her to the hospice. And I'll always remember the fuss that was made about that poor old lady. And the first thing they did for her was to take her for a bath.
Yeah.
And I thought it was the greatest sign of love, and all because of your handiwork and your good work, Eileen, and what you thought up in your heart, what came into your heart, yeah, and you dreamed of, and it became a reality. And it certainly became a reality for that poor old lady. I presume she has passed on since, but I think she died like an angel. Thank you, Eileen. May God bless you, and I hope to see you when I get home next year.
Happy birthday, Dr. Sister Eileen. We are so happy that God has given you this time to reach 80th birthday. And it's very rare people who does reach. And how can I say? What I can say is God loves you. Without the God's love, we are nothing. But with God's love, we can live so many years, and you can do so many things which you have already done, which you are planning to do. And for this, God really appreciates the works which you have been doing. Because as we live, Dr. Keane, we haven't seen God, or we haven't heard His voice, but we see God through people, especially through you, Sister Eileen. So that's why we are saying God is love, God is love. And we love you so much from the bottom of our hearts. You have given us joy, even for the less privileged people in society. You care for them. Why do you so? You do so because the God cares for you. And in return, you return the love of God to the people who are less privileged. So we are very grateful to wish you a very happy birthday, 8th birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear King. Happy birthday to you.
I hope you have a very happy birthday. Congratulations. I wish I was with you to celebrate, but I'll be thinking of you. I'll always remember you, Dr. Keane, how kind you were to my husband when he was so ill, the troubles, the pains you took to come and visit him, encourage him and me. I needed that so badly, and you stood by me in those hard times. May God bless you. I remember, Dr. Keane, when you came on a holiday a few years ago to Ndola, you took a walk from the Dominican convent to come and visit me. I was really honored. I was greatly moved to think that you took the trouble to come down to visit an old friend. Now I'm hoping that one day you'll have again a holiday to come to Zambia and we'll meet up again, talk of the good old days, and just to see you would be such a great pleasure. So I hope to hear that you will come sometime.
Hey,